Good morning, dear students. Today, we will talk about the strong nuclear forces. We are still in Unit 5. This is Chapter 1, Lesson 2. We're going to start Lesson 2. This will be Part 1. Strong nuclear forces. What are the strong nuclear forces? We all know that the nucleus consists of protons, which are positively charged, and neutrons, which are neutral or don't have charge. And we know there is two types of forces inside the nucleus. One force is between the protons and the neutrons, which is attractive force, and another is a repulsive force, repulsive between the positive protons and each other. So what keeps the nucleus stable although we have a repulsive force inside the nucleus? So they found that there is a strong nuclear force. The nucleus keep its stability in spite of the huge electric repulsive force, which is called Coulomb electric force, between the positive protons compared to the small attractive force between the nucleons. Due to the presence of forces working on combining these nucleons. What is meant by nucleons? We know that nucleons means protons and neutrons, which are found inside the nucleus. Okay, this is called strong nuclear force. These forces are named by the strong nuclear force because they have a great effect on the nucleons inside the small nucleus. We have some properties of this nuclear forces, which that they have a great power. Number two, they do not depend on the type of the charge of the nucleon, so they can be between a proton and another proton, a proton and neutron, or neutron and another neutron. Number three, they have a short range, or they do not affect far objects. Nuclear binding energy. Mass is accurate measurements prove that the mass of the binded nucleons or the protons and neutrons binded together is called actual mass, which is less than the mass of the free nucleons, which is called the theoretical mass. So we have two types of forces having different masses. We have the mass of the nucleons when they are binded together, and we have another force when they are separated. Okay, so when they are binded together, this is called the actual mass, and when they are separated or free nucleons, this is called theoretical mass. They found that they are not equal. Okay, there is a difference between them. They call this difference the mass effect. What is the difference of this mass help us? This mass will be then converted into energy, which will be the nuclear binding energy, or the energy which keeps the stability of the nucleus, will be equal to this mass. Calculation of the mass defect. How can I calculate the mass defect? The loss in the mass, or what is called the mass defect, can be calculated by theoretical mass minus the actual mass. We have here an example. If you have the actual mass of a helium is 4.00150 unit, while the theoretical mass is 4.031888 U, the answer will be the mass defect equal to theoretical mass minus the actual mass, which is equal to 4.03188 minus 4.0015. As you can see here, there is a difference between the two numbers. This difference, we can get it by subtracting theoretical minus actual. So we have the mass defect equal 0.03038 U. Thank you so much.